What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, and today I'm bringing you a brand new video where we're going to be talking about the best infantry equipment in Rise of Kingdoms. Dude, they added a katana to the game. You know I had to craft this as soon as possible. I put it on my Alex. He's running around the open field, just slashing people. It's nuts. Now, in all seriousness, I want to apologize really quick for the lack of uploads over the last couple of days. This video right here, I tried to record like 5 times, and when I finally got the version of the video recorded that I enjoyed, when I went back to edit it, the end of the video just cut off somehow. I don't know what happened, but at that point it was already like midnight and I just had no other time to record this week, so I just had no choice but to not record, and it drove me crazy. Now, I did make a post on YouTube explaining this, and I also mentioned that I did have my city get rallied. If you guys want to see a video covering my city rally and things that I think that I did well, things that I think that I did poorly, make sure this video gets 100 likes and I will upload that video as soon as possible. Now let me indulge my diet soda addiction. Hang on. So what we're going to be talking about in this video is kind of where you should start as a free-to-play player or a brand new player in Rise of Kingdoms. What is kind of the base set of equipment that you should work towards for your infantry? And then we're going to talk about the upgrade path. So should you go to the green tier? Should you go to the blue tier? Should you skip that and go to the purple tier? We're going to be talking about all that in this video. Yo, somebody's dropping stacks, boys. Ooh, heck yeah, dude. Now, before we go anywhere, this is a general equipment tip, but if you haven't done the Blacksmith Apprentice side quest line, I would start working on it immediately by crafting and disenchanting some gray materials. This quest line will give you a ton of amazing rewards, blueprints, all that good stuff. And if you're a low spender, some of the bundles that pop up during certain key points in this quest line are 100% worth purchasing. Some of them are $3, some of them are $5. Regardless, they're all very, very good value, and I highly recommend them if you are a low spender. With all that out of the way, let's talk about the weapon slots, okay? Your starter weapon for infantry commanders is going to be the Blessed Blade. This will give you a 6% infantry health buff, which is great. This is a green item, which means it's very easy to obtain. Since it takes a total of 80 green materials, it will take around 6 days of blacksmith material production time in order to get enough materials for the Blessed Blade, which is a relatively short period of time. Now, all of the times that I'm going to be referencing in this video, I double checked myself, but they were also given to me in a spreadsheet over on Discord from a Discord user by the name of Uga Booga. I don't know what that's a reference for, but anyway, if you're watching, thank you so much. So the Blessed Blade, it's a green item, which means we're skipping the gray tier. This is a great item because health is the best stat for infantry, so getting it on your green item is excellent. The blue tier, we have the Gatekeeper Shield, and I would honestly recommend skipping this item. Prior to this update, this was a really good piece of equipment. However, at this point in the game, I don't really think it's that worth it because it's only 2% more infantry stats than the Blessed Blade. And if you get the special talent on the Blessed Blade, then they give the same amount of infantry health. So I think the Gatekeeper Shield is something that you can safely skip for most players. If you are a bigger spender and you're kind of working your way up, or you know, if you feel like you need those extra 2%, then go ahead and do it. But keep in mind, the materials for this are 18 days of material production time, which is significantly more. Even if you go ahead and dismantle the Blessed Blade, it's still 12 more days. And I think if you just stick with the Blessed Blade and start producing those materials for something else, it'll have a much more substantial impact on your build. It also costs 2 million gold, whereas this only costs 1 million. So I think for what you're getting, this isn't worth it. And again, if you special talent, absolutely, definitely, obviously not worth it. Now, really quick about special talents, you'll see this box of text on every single piece of weapon or equipment that you can forge in the game. They don't ever actually tell us what the special talent chance is. So anytime you forge a piece of equipment, there's a chance that you can get a special talent for it. It's somewhere in the realm of 15 to 20% is from my experience and from what I've heard from other players. So keep that in mind. It's very unlikely to get a special talent, but it is possible. And so if you do, obviously for the course of this video, you're going to want to put the special talent on your infantry commanders, and that'll increase its effectiveness by 30%, rounding up to the nearest half percent. So after the Blessed Blade, you have the katana, baby. You have the katana, and obviously you want to go for that katana. Even if you have the special talent on the Blessed Blade, this is definitely an item that you want to get because it gives you 13% of infantry stats. Now, it is in the form of attack, but that's still a very, very good item, especially on somebody like Alexander or even on somebody like Sun Tzu. This is a really great item. Highly recommend working your way towards this. Now, it's important to realize that I think you should actually get something in every single slot here for infantry before you start working on upgrades for each particular slot. So for most players, the upgrade path is going to be Blessed Blade straight to Sakura Fubuki. And then if you're a big spender, you're going to go for Shield of the Eternal Empire, or when they introduce the level 50 equipment, then you'll go for that. Next, we're going to talk about the helmet, and this is where things start to get a little bit less straightforward. The Iron Helmet is a gray piece of equipment. It gives you 3% infantry attack. That's incredibly valuable for the amount of investment that it takes to actually get this item. This literally takes 24 hours of material production time, and boom, you have enough for the Iron Helm. You're going to get the blueprints really easy, very fast, through the side quest that I was talking about before. Plus, you get it from tavern quests, courier station, everywhere. You're gonna have tons of this. It's gonna be easy to craft. Now, the next thing to note is that the green piece of equipment here actually gives you less stats. So skip this, obviously, right? You don't want to spend more materials for less of a gain. Even Helm of the Phoenix also gives infantry. Definitely not worth it. What I would recommend actually is craft the Iron Helm, then I would dismantle it and craft it again until you get that special talent, because like I said, it's relatively cheap in terms of gold. You're gonna get the materials back when you dismantle it anyway, and you're gonna get those blueprints over and over and over again. So you're gonna have plenty of blueprints and plenty of opportunities to craft this, and it'll be relatively easy to do so. And I think by doing that over and over, eventually you're going to get that special talent. It should happen within the first like 3 or 4 or maybe 5 crafts of it. So it'll be pretty quick. And when you do that, you'll get an extra percentage point. So this will give you 4% infantry attack, which is just significantly better than the green items. Now, let's look at the blue tier and see if there's anything worth here that's worth stopping for, right? Because like I said, it's going to be really easy for you to get the special talent on the Iron Helmet. And if we look at the Windswept War Helm, it only gives you 0.5% more than you would get from the special talent on your Iron Helmet. So is the Windswept War Helm worth it? Well, not really, but there is a specific instance where it might be, and that is where you could implement 2 pieces for a 2% attack buff. That would be worth it if you can come up with another piece of Windswept equipment somewhere else in your build to get you that 2% attack. And obviously that replacement would have to also make sense as well. So technically replacing your Iron Helmet with the Windswept War Helm is 0.5% better, but I still wouldn't recommend it unless you can fit something else into your build. So we're going to come back to the Windswept set and in what instance I think it would be worth stopping to get. But for most players, as far as the helmet goes, you're probably going to skip it. We can look at other things like the Expedition Worm Helm. This gives you less stats than you would get from even the Iron Helmet without the special talent. So this is a clear one that you want to skip. And after that, we're looking at purple tier and the Witch's Lineage. By the way, this piece of equipment looks insane. Like, this is one of the best looking helmets in the game, and it's a purple tier. It just looks wicked. Like, it looks like demonic or something. I don't know. I think it looks super cool. I cannot wait to get my hands on this, but this is another infantry attack buff. So between this and the katana, you're going to be looking at 21% infantry attack, and way more than that if you get the special talent, which would be incredibly lucky. Make your way towards this, but for the majority of you, and for the most of your playtime, you're going to be using the special talent on the Iron Helmet, and you should feel pretty good about that, because again, 4% of stats is half as much as the number of stats you're getting on an epic piece of equipment. So the gray here is incredibly good. Make your way towards this eventually. Next, we're going to be looking at the chest piece for infantry, and just like the weapon, there is no gray piece of equipment here for infantry, which is fine because we have the infantry breastplate, which gives you 4% infantry defense, which is totally good for this slot. Now, it's worth noting, right, that this is going to be the piece that you start with, obviously, and When we move over to the blue tier, we see another piece of windswept equipment, and it's only 0.5% more than the green tier. So my gut is saying, don't even worry about the windswept set because it's not worth it. However, there is sort of an exception to that rule, okay? Now, if you can get the windswept breastplate and the windswept helmet, then it technically would give you 3% more stats than sticking around with the gray and the green in this tier. Is 3% of stats worth it? Maybe, right? It might be for you, and you guys can make that decision, but it's also worth noting you do get the march speed as well, and you get it on both of those. So you're getting 6% march speed and 3% more stats. Again, it's 0.5% for each piece plus the 2% for the two-piece set bonus. So I would say maybe it's worth it for most of you to go ahead and get the windswept chest as long as you can get the windswept helmet as well. And it's important to note that I would only replace the chest slot and the helmet slot when you can do both at the same time for the windswept set, because you're not actually seeing a huge benefit from only replacing one, right? Maybe 0.5%. So I would wait and hold off to see if you get enough blueprints of both and if it makes sense for you to do that in terms of how much materials that you need, right? We're talking about quite a long time. When we combined the material production time needed for both of these, we're looking at 12 days of material production time for the war helmet, for the windswept war helmet, and the windswept breastplate is also 12 days. So 24 total days of production time. That's almost like more than 3 weeks, 3.5 weeks. That's a long time, right? And it's only, again, it's only 0.5% for each slot. It's only worth it if you can do that set bonus. Now, if you produce the infantry breastplate and you get the special talent, it will be better than the windswept chest plate, right? Or chest piece, whatever it's called. Windswept breastplate, whatever. So if you get the special talent here, well, then it's automatically just not worth it to go for the other pieces, right? Because that's going to give you 5.5% of infantry defense at that point. So you'd be really switching to the windswept set for a significant amount of materials plus the gold for a very small buff in your stats plus some march speed. I don't know. I don't really think it's worth it in terms of battle stats, right? If you are a medium, if you're a small spender or a medium spender, then maybe. But honestly, if you get the special talent here on the infantry breastplate, I would say skipping the windswept set wouldn't be the worst thing that you could do. And either way, either you're going to go from the infantry breastplate or the windswept breastplate, eventually you're going to be making your way over here to Quinsole. And would you look at that? It's got 8% infantry attack. So I think you guys are seeing the pattern here. Your infantry marches are going to have a ton of attack stats, which is honestly, it's not the stat that I would want preferably on my infantry. I would rather see health or defense as opposed to attack, but it is what it is. It's still more stats, which I think at the end of the day, if you were to go out and do the math, I think in most scenarios, you're still going to be better off with more stats, even if they are in a specific stat that isn't optimal for that troop type. So Quinsole is going to be eventually what you're looking at here in the infantry tier for that purple piece of equipment on your chest. Now, eventually you can make your way over to Plate of the Eternal Empire if you're trying to get the set bonuses here, or you can get the Hope Cloak, which will actually give you infantry defense, which is really, really good. Again, you see attack here, which is crazy. Infantry defense at 12% for the Hope Cloak, I think is better, unless you are a really high spender who's going to be getting the set bonuses for infantry, right? If you're going to get the entire Eternal Empire set, then just completely skip the Hope Cloak. If not, this is a great piece of equipment that you can eventually work towards, but it's going to take a crazy amount of time. I mean, let's take a look here, right? If we look at the production time, it is 192 days. So that's a crazy jump from Quinsole, which was 48 days, right? It's like four times more at least, which I guess that makes sense because it's four times the material needed. Regardless, we're learning math together, okay? Let's move on to the gloves. Luckily, infantry has a gray piece of gloves that give you infantry defense, and the cloth gloves, not only are they super easy to get blueprints for, but it takes 18 hours of material production time to get enough of this iron ore to produce the cloth gloves. How you turn iron into cloth, I have no idea. You gotta ask Lilith, but regardless, this is a great piece of equipment, and just like the iron helmet over here, You're going to want to craft this over and over again until you get the special talent, which is going to bump you up to 3% infantry defense, which is really good. Now, if we look at the bronze bracers, completely worthless. We look at leather gloves, completely worthless. Again, this is for infantry. Obviously, that would not be the case if you were talking about cavs or archers, but for infantry, you don't need either of those. So let's move on to the gloves in the blue tier, and we see Calvin's hand, which is really interesting, and we see another piece of windswept equipment. Now, I don't know about you, but 3% of infantry defense on my cloth gloves versus the 2.5% infantry health on windswept bracers, I think I would rather have the defense. I think I would. I mean, it's just more stats, right? Now, you are getting the march speed, and I don't want to devalue that march speed. I think march speed is very important, but we're talking about, you know, free to play and low spenders. What are the odds that they're going to have enough tech done to outspeed a T5 player or a big spender in the open field, and that this 3% is going to make the difference? I don't think that's reasonable, right? I don't think that there's going to be very many instances where that's the case. Now, it is worth noting that if you did get the special talent on the green chest and you do want to upgrade your helmet to the windswept, then you could upgrade your gray cloth gloves to the windswept bracers, and that would give you technically more stats than had you not done that. So that's something to consider if you really want that march speed, that extra 6% plus the 2% attack, but you got the special talent here, then you could forego upgrading your chest in an effort to upgrade your helmet and your gloves. And I think that would get this, that would get the same set bonus here, and it would make logical sense. But again, if you skip the windswept set entirely, I don't think that you should feel bad about that, because you're saving these material production, right? The materials that you're producing for these for the next tier of equipment. And what we're going to be looking at here is Seth's Brutality. Now, this is 5.5% of infantry defense. And if you remember, 3% on cloth gloves, you're not even doubling it, right? So I don't know. The gloves are probably one of the last things that I would upgrade, because the amount of stats that you get is just kind of less significant than other pieces. Now, it's worth noting that this is 32 days of craft time, so it's less than something like your chest, because it is using only 40 pieces of material, where I believe this uses 60, if I'm not mistaken. 60. So that's why it's just less material, less stats. Makes sense. Mathematically, it probably comes out to be about the same, but regardless, I still think that gloves are one of the last things you should worry about upgrading, because cloth gloves, you make them, you get the special talent, you're looking pretty good. Now, one last thing about the windswept set: it uses iron and leather to craft, and that's because iron is the main material for infantry, leather is the main material for cavalry, and it favors both pretty equally, right? And what's unfortunate about that is that if you were to dismantle this, you couldn't just straight up take those materials and use them towards the purple piece of equipment, because this uses ebony, and pretty much every other infantry thing uses primary iron, secondary ebony. So that's the downside about going to windswept. It's that you can't even really recoup the entirety of that production time for your infantry set. Now, of course, you're still going to use leather for your other, you know, for like calves and stuff, right? So it's not like that material is going to be useless, but we're talking about focusing on infantry. And so it will slow down your infantry set, you know, going from cloth to purple, right? It'll slow down that progression if you do stop at the windswept bracers, because when you dismantle, you don't get all the materials that you need for the purple tier. Hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully you guys understand that. Let's move on to legs, where we're going to be starting with the Ranger trousers. This will give you 4% infantry attack. I don't know about you, but I'm getting tired of that infantry attack, man. I want some tankiness on my equipment, okay? I want some tankiness, but we're not going to get it here. So there's no grays for infantry here. Vanguard is totally for cavs, and there's no other greens, right? So it is what it is. There's not even any low tier equipment for archers, which is interesting for the legs. I don't know why they did that here. Obviously, you're not going to get the coarse breeches. They should change this to archers. I don't know what's going on, but anyway, we're doing Ranger trousers first, then we're going to be looking at the blue legs. Okay, we're looking at the blue legs. Sentry breeches, 6% attack, 2% extra stats to go from green to blue. I just don't see it. I don't see that being worth it, especially if you special talent here. And, you know, we're looking at the same scenario as your weapon, right? We were talking about Blessed Blade versus the Gatekeeper Shield. It's 2% of stats, man. I don't think it's worth it. You can save those materials and just go to the next tier, right? And we're looking at the Kurok's Humility. We're looking at Iron and Leather. So that's kind of where it's not exactly appropriate to go to the Sentry Breaches, because you're making Iron and Ebony here, and then when you go to the Sentry Breaches, like, yeah, you'll be able to get back the Iron and the Leather, but if you dismantle this, then this Ebony is not going to be worth it to be put towards the next tier, because it's not used in Kurok's Humility. So I would say probably just skip over the blue tier here. Again, Ranger's Trousers, go right to the Kurok's Humility. This will give you Infantry Health, which is what you want. This is the stat we've been looking for all along. So eventually you do get it here in the Kurok's Humility. And this is definitely one of the best pieces for your infantry armies because of that 8% infantry health. And if you're able to get that special talent on here, like, oof, you are sitting pretty for your legs. You don't even have to worry about the legendary equipment here. I mean, you could go towards Eternal Knight. I did actually craft this for my Alexander. And I also crafted it because if I ever have to defend my city, wink, wink, this is a pretty good piece to have on whoever's on your wall. So I like this piece of equipment, but we're talking legendaries here, right? This is crazy amount of craft time. If we're looking at the leggings, Kurok's Humility is 48 days of craft time, and the Eternal Light is 192. So again, a lot more time because it's a lot more materials, but eventually you should be working towards this or the Eternal Empire, obviously. Now, the downside here is that this is, again, infantry attack, whereas this is infantry defense, and it's a little bit more. There's no set bonus here, but I think defense is a little bit better on infantry. So it depends. If you're a mega whale, just go for this set. But if you're not, if you're just like a medium spender, or maybe a bigger spender, then you might want to stop at Eternal Knight. Finally, let's talk about boots. The green boots are going to be your starting equipment, the Boots of Reverence. I actually don't like this piece of equipment. I don't know why. I think not only is it ugly, right? I think it's ugly, but also you're getting more infantry attack, and it's only a small amount. It's not that much. It's 2.5%. If you look at something like the Gray Helmet, like, dude, this thing gives you more stats as a gray than this gives you as a green. I don't know. Boots of the Reverence, but regardless, this is where you're going to be starting. It gives you some more infantry attack. Great. Let's move on. Scarlet Hounds are a blue piece of equipment, and you could technically be looking at the Windswept Boots as well. Now, we're looking at 2.5% for infantry defense. This is 2.5% infantry attack. Is it worth spending those materials for a lateral move, right? It's not an improvement, it's just a change in stats. I think for most players, it's just not worth stopping at this piece. And I think if you're going to go for the two pieces of Windswept to get that set bonus, the boots are probably not one that you're going to want. You're most likely going to go for gloves and helmet, or maybe chest and helmet or chest and gloves. But if you get that special talent on the chest, maybe you don't need it. So I don't know. Boots, I would say probably just skip for infantry. Now, you could get the Scarlet Hounds. It gives you 4% infantry health, and I think that it's only an extra 1.5%, but it is a better stat for infantry. It's up to you if you want to stop here. Now, if you do, keep in mind, you could actually dismantle this and use all of those materials to get 10 epic pieces of iron. So that would get you a third of the way there for the iron needed for the Frost Treads, which is ultimately what you're going to be going for. That's 5.5% of infantry defense. Now, if you do stop at the Scarlet Hounds and you do get that special talent, well, then you're going to have 5.5% infantry's health, which I think is actually better than 5.5% infantry defense. So stopping at the Scarlet Hounds, it may slow you down slightly to go for the purple, and it's gonna cost you 2 million gold, obviously, to go ahead and do that. I would say, you know, if you decide to skip the Scarlet Hounds, that's fine, but if you do stop here, it's fine. The boots, I have the hardest time giving you a direct path, because it's just such small amount of stats, and I don't know. I just, yeah, I mean, I guess if you're cool with dismantling the Scarlet Hounds because you're going to be able to use all this iron for the next piece, then yeah, if you've got the gold, I would say stop here just for the chance at that special talent, because if you get it, you could basically stop for your boots. Now, eventually, you're going to make your way up to like Shio's Return, for example. This is what I'm currently working on. I'm 10 legendary iron ore away, so I'm super, super close. I'm happy about that. This is 8% infantry defense. I think it's a really great piece to have, not only for this, but also for your wall as well. And like I said, for everything else, the Eternal Empire is the set you want to go for if you're a mega, mega spender, because this set is going to give you that Empire set bonus. it's just worth it because of that. It's great. But if not, then Shio's Return is a good option as well. Wow, I did not think that this video would be this long. So if you guys made it all the way to the end, hopefully you guys will drop a thumbs up on it. Remember, 100 likes and I will upload the video of my city getting a rally, baby. And of course, if you're new around here, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Click that bell to be notified the next time that I upload a Rise of Kingdoms video. Comment down below any questions that you have about equipment or about infantry equipment specifically. I will try to answer as many of you as I can. As always, links to my social media accounts are in the description below. So if you want to catch up with me on Instagram or Twitter or over on Twitch where I live stream Rise of Kingdoms, or you can even join my Discord down below as well, where you can come and just join and talk and ask me questions there as well. On the days that I don't upload, I probably post at least on my Instagram story. So if you guys want to like actually keep up with me like as a person, then that's the place to do it. Finally, there is a link down below to download Rise of Kingdoms absolutely for free for your PC or your Mac. It's a program called BlueStacks. That's how I'm playing right now, and I experienced the least amount of crashes compared to like an older phone, and it's free. I would say give it a try. It's my favorite way to play the game. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.